Westpac is under fire for sacking hundreds of IT workers and sending their jobs overseas. And to add insult to injury, before they leave, they're being forced to train their foreign replacements.
Americo Paita has worked as an IT expert at Westpac for the past 6 years, but now the bank has decided to outsource his job and he's being made redundant.
It's going to be hard. I still have to actually keep going, working. I still own my house.
More than 200 Westpac IT workers are being shown the door, but before they go, they're training Indian workers to do their jobs.
Westpac clients, they are very high-level IT personnel. As far as I'm concerned, they are not.
These jobs are being outsourced, many of them are going offshore, and the workers are left wondering what's going to happen next.
Westpac says we are changing our business model to adjust to the lower growth environment. With more job cuts on the way, Westpac staff are worried.
We won't know until March what's going to happen with our jobs, so we're sitting here trying to carry on the best we can.
Westpac made a profit of $6.9 billion last year. Chief Executive Gail Kelly took home more than $8.6 million.
And I hope the banks are mindful of the views of Australians about Australian jobs.
Instead of announcing all of its redundancies in one hit, Westpac has managed to limit the bad publicity by laying off smaller numbers of workers over several months. So far, Westpac has fired 1,156 workers. Thousands more could soon follow. John Hill, 10 News.